man.
Finals are over with. Just got done with my last exam. It's summertime. It's time to put in some work with my guys. Yo, Quez, what you doing this summer, bro?
What aren't we doing? There's so much stuff here to do here in Knoxville. But you know we got to put that work here in the weight room. Got to make sure we watch film, getting ourselves ready and prepared for this fall. When I'm not at the complex, you know, watching film or working out, you can catch me here in downtown Knox. You know we got to hoop a little bit too. And in Knoxville, you can't beat the views. You know we still putting in that work, and we having fun. Ball, summer long.
Happy graduation weekend to all the people that are graduating. I'm very excited to be on stage with you guys, and I'm definitely very excited to have my family there, especially my mom. It's Mother's Day weekend, and I get to have the chance to hang out and just do Mother's Day with my mama, so. Have a good weekend and go Vols. I feel like getting my degree is a stepping stone for myself and my family, and I'm very excited to actually get mine. I dedicated myself to academics and football at the same time, and I think that along the way I was able to prepare myself for life. So when I hear my name called at graduation,
Jarrett James Garantano.
The one thing that's really gonna stick home to me is my grandma. I know my grandma always wanted to be there, and she can't make it now, she's in New Jersey, but when I'm walking across, I'm gonna think of her and thank her for all the things she's done for me in my life.
Proud of you.
Not yet, 2 years left.
There's definitely emotions. I know that I have two more football seasons coming, so I know I'm not leaving just yet, but I definitely look forward to the new memories that I'm gonna make and hopefully continue to make them as I get my master's degree.
I ain't gonna lie, I'm a mama's boy. Tell me, I was a good kid.
My mom is definitely the embarrassing mom.
All right, now I got in trouble a lot as a kid, so her best impression would be Danie Yaka, Nako Beta Yo. And basically that means, come here so I can whoop you.
Brand, did you do your homework? You gotta do what you gotta do so you can do what you wanna do.
Her favorite line during the games was woody woo woo and all that. She was, I don't know where she got it from. But
she loves embarrass me by saying I run too slow sometimes on the field. Oh, me and my mom got a good relationship, so she ain't gonna make me look crazy in front of nobody.
She would play old school music in the car, like Biggie Smalls or Tupac, wind down the windows and look outside and nod her head to everybody out there.
My mom throws down on anything, but I love her soul food.
She's from Jamaica, so probably jerk chicken and rice and peas.
But I'm gonna just say the best answer. Everything she cooks is the best thing she cooks.
Definitely chicken parm and ravioli. She got it from my grandma, and she makes it the best now. The other day, I saw a picture of myself and my mom. I think we were at Chuck E. Cheese, and I had a Tennessee hat on. I think it was 10 years ago. And surprisingly, I don't know how a New Jersey kid got the Tennessee hat, but that's definitely one of my favorite pictures with my mom.
I feel like this picture just describes our relationship. I like this picture because of the smiles just on her face after a game. It just shows how much enjoyment she has being my number one fan.
Hey mom, I want you to know I'm always thinking about you. I love you, and happy Mother's Day.
Ma, I just want to thank you, you know, for your endless love. Without you, I wouldn't be in the position that I am today.
Mama, happy Mother's Day. I love you so much. Thank you for everything you did for me. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. Love you. Appreciate you, everything you did for me.
And I just want to say happy Mother's Day, and I love you a lot.
Happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. We love y'all.
Man, Mother's Day was awesome, man. I called my mom back home. She had a great time. But now I'm in this photo shoot. I got a 20-on, representing the class of 2020 to the top. Man, we need y'all here. We're going to be using all these photos on a whole bunch of UT stuff, at Vol Football on Twitter, on Instagram. Now you know who's behind the visor.
Today we're providing some opportunity for the administrators, coaches, athletics, professors as well to ride on the Blackhawk helicopters, and I think they're excited about it.
This is a bucket list type thing, to be able to jump in and fly around, check out Knoxville, check out campus from a different perspective. I'm really excited.
The folks riding on the Blackhawk helicopters are flying open doors out there, so different than flying on an airplane, you get a different experience out there. And even the pilots will take them on some of the ups and downs that a helicopter is capable of doing.
Well, I have so much respect for the ROTC program and these fellows. I think it's really important to have that relationship and have that support from us.
We want to be the best partners and teammates here on Rocky Top in order for us to both accomplish our missions.
Hey, this is Coach Johnson, man. How you guys doing? It's summertime in Knoxville, man. Right here on Rocky Top, man. We're doing the kids doing a great job kind of working out with Coach Fitz, man, getting after it. That's one of the things we're going to do this summer, man. We're going to have a lot of fun this summer trying to find a way to get better. Hey, hope you guys got a chance to see my mic it up, man. See how we kind of getting after guys, coaching them up.
Keep moving your feet.
You look for kids who want to compete at all times. That's in the classroom. Whatever they're doing, they want to be the best.
Go, full speed. Go. Go. Don't stop. Don't stop. You're trying to duck. You're trying to stay with it. Hey, stop trying to duck your head. Shoot your hand. You get nervous because he's talking about to run through you. Boom. Shoot your hand.
Honor to receive this award. A lot of hard work goes into this, studying each and every night, making sure work is done, and balancing schoolwork. And I'm very appreciative of this award and to be recognized. And oh yeah, congrats to my boy Matt too.
Appreciate it, Bruiser. It really is an honor to get this award, especially coming from a black man who is so committed to his sport and to his education and his scholarship. It's not easy balancing sports and school. You know, they're both very time consuming. They're both very challenging, but it's all about attention to detail and time management. I have a commitment to my education and my scholarship, and I have a love for my sport. So that makes it just even all the more harder. But you know, this upcoming summer, I'm gonna balance it the best that I can, finish out the summer with a 4.0, go into fall camp, dominate fall camp, and we're gonna lead this team to victory all fall.